Arizona hosts the Oregon schools this week, giving them an opportunity to avenge two of their four Pac-12 losses this season. But the Wildcats aren't heading into their games seeking revenge.
No, somebody told me a long time ago, revenge kills you. So, you know, it's you start thinking in those terms, it's not healthy in any way, shape, or form. For us, what we want to do is, especially as the calendar turns to late February, we just want to play well. We want to play good basketball. We want to be the best team that we can be. There's always different things from the previous game or games that we're trying to respond and fix and improve. You know, we didn't shoot the ball very well at Cal and at Stanford. And as you guys know, we've had these halves in a game, not the entire game, but a half, where it's just a head scratcher. You know, we go cold and, you know, so confidence, taking good shots, executing, being a more consistent shooting team. If I put a silver lining on it, you know, it's not as if we just came off this red hot shooting streak in which, you know, our offense carried us to victory. That's the furthest thing from the way it happened. We're an improving defensive team. We out-rebounded Stanford. We took care of the ball, especially at Cal, and we were able to leave with two good road wins. But this week, my hope is that we can be a more efficient, better shooting team against both Oregon State and Oregon.
Arizona has performed better coming off of losses during Pac-12 play, but this week, Sean Miller hopes to reverse that trend.
I mean, you could look at that eight different ways. You know, back to my point, the teams that we've had that have won the conference or, you know, have had a great Pac-12 season, it's because we've kept the focus on what we can control. And as you know, there's tough moments in the conference season, there's tough losses and there's big wins, and it's just so much about handling it. Our team this year has done better preparing when we've come off of tough losses than when we've had good moments. And this is a big challenge because we're coming off of a road sweep, and we have obviously a homestand which features two teams that beat us. So it's a great challenge for us to prepare and have a chance to beat Oregon State on Thursday. And that's our focus.
Josh Green and Nico Mannion have been streaky with their shooting this season, but Sean Miller doesn't seem to be worried as he feels they have great coachability, while Max Hazzard believes it's only a matter of time until they break out of the slump.
You know, obviously Nico, he's different than Josh, and they have a different style, but you know, it's just a matter of time before Nico breaks through. You know, similar to Dylan, he can't let what has happened or the last game or the last shot affect the shot he's taking or the next game or the next week. And, you know, when you're a young player, in particular Nico, you know, there's so much pressure on him to perform. But to your point, he does a lot of other very, very important things for our team. And one of the aspects of his game that I'm really the most pleased with, and I think it bodes well to his future and ours, is he's a continuing, improving defensive player. He defends his man better. He's in a better position off the ball. He makes more defensive plays for our team. He's more consistent. And that's really helped us become a better defensive team. He did a really good job in the Bay Area in both games on that, you know, side of the basketball. That's also good because, you know, he didn't have his two best games overall on offense. So being a more of a two-way player, being better at both sides, and he's running our team more efficiently. One of the reasons that Zeke had, you know, a great weekend last week is our guards in particular did a good job of getting him the ball in scoring position, and Nico was at the tail end of that a lot of different times. So with Nico, it's taking good shots, it's watching the ball go in, and I have no doubt, it wouldn't surprise me at all if this week isn't a big week for him. Yeah, and you know, Josh took some really good shots at Stanford and Cal, and he takes good shots. No problem. I mean, we want him to shoot it. He's a good shooter. He may be a little bit more streaky, but as evidenced by a number of different games this year, you give him a couple open looks, and he can knock them down. But we challenged Josh before this last trip to get back on the defensive rebounding side. You know, in the non-conference play, he's one of our best defensive rebounders, and he slipped in Pac-12 play, but you know, in both games, Stanford and Cal, he had a lot of defensive rebounds. And man, our team is so much better defensively and rebounding. And, you know, one of Josh's gifts is the open court. And when he gets a defensive rebound, he pushes the ball. And a lot of good things happen when he has the ball in his hands in the open court. So he put himself in that position more often on the last trip by rebounding better. And, you know, again, it was great to see him respond. Again, no different than Zeke, Christian, and Nico. You know, these guys are young, and they learn, and they can continue to grow and get better with each experience. For example, you know, playing on the road against a zone defense, Oregon State zone, a month and a half ago, whenever that was, you know, he's much more prepared. He's much more at ease and comfortable offensively against that type of defense now than he would have been then, just because of his experience. And, you know, and those guys, thing that I love about all of them, the younger players, is they all have really good attitudes. They're coachable. They want to learn. They don't have all the answers. Sometimes, you know, showing them the mistakes they made from the previous game, it's an eye-opener. You know, that's maybe the best way they can learn. But most of the time, they work hard to repair it and become better.
I think it's just a matter of time, man. I do. I think it's basketball. It's the first time, you know, going around in college. And, you know, it's a long season. Sometimes you're going to shoot well. Sometimes you're not. They're in the gym. You know, we practice hard. So I like their chances of getting back rolling, you know, here pretty soon.